I lost my eyes. I imagined some celestial version of a cornea or retina, but I could only feel a flickering light. I sensed myself standing in front of a giant mirror, showing trillions of other humans flittering inside my own body. Each reflection synced to one specific skittering note of a scale, sung by a star from the spiral arms of diverging galaxies. I lost my lungs. Without bronchioles or alveoli, I kept gasping in my dizziness and giddy exhilaration. I flew through the air like I did in my dreams. I wasn't soaring like Superman through the clouds, but rather willing myself up and down some string of vertical buoyancy across the universe. I lost my limbs. My body dissolved into a pool of what looked like computerized tomography scans. Every anatomical system, organ, tissue, and cell disappeared into an ocean of other people's bodily remnants. My atheist parents joked that they actually believed in every religion, just in case. I took this sentiment literally by reading copious amounts of text on Christianity, Islam, Hinduism, and Buddhism. Fear paralyzed me when I thought of abject nothingness after I died. It seemed far preferable to instead contemplate all the best possibilities of heaven. But I didn't meet any human-like figures whatsoever. No angels or glowing ghosts greeted me. My deceased friends and family members weren't waiting for my arrival. But I had an intangible feeling encompassing all of my loved ones, living and dead, and their overwhelming presence embraced me like a warm blanket. I realized that I had floated into a spiraling tower made entirely of glass. I flew up and down the center spine. The walls rotated around me at different angles, like the paths of electrons orbiting a nucleus. Each electron shell that darted past me held a brief moment of human beings potentially connecting to one another. I got glimpses from my life, but also, overwhelmingly, I felt the emotions and memories of every person on the planet, living, dead, and yet to be born. Every atom belonging to me also belonged to everyone else. All the dreams and memories of myself and my loved ones swirled around me into a colossal, circular, and transparent tunnel. In life, I was inside this ring, moving in one direction. In death, I am now in the center, seeing my entire life with no beginning, no middle, no end. I thought of how Ray Cummings wrote, "Time is nature's way to keep everything from happening all at once." Susan Sontag added that space exists, so it doesn't all happen to you. In death, time was gone. Everything was happening at once. And without a body, it was all happening to me. Suddenly, the stench of smoke and ashes rained upon me when I began thinking about the obscenely rich, powerful, and disgusting man who hurt me, whose avarice, anger, and insecurities devastated countless lives around the world. I remembered all the terrible people, politicians, and polemic media supporting him, sustaining him, and stoking widespread fear and false narratives during global catastrophes. I don't care if they burned for their sins and death. They already created hell on earth for the living. I realized that I had a choice. I could return to the physical life I lost, or remain in a state of enlightened, post-corporeal existence. Why would anyone go back? I took a deep breath as if I still had a mouth, trachea, and a functioning pair of lungs. I have unfinished business. I have work to do.